Hello and welcome to another episode of the Top 3 Pan series. My name is Joost Appelboom and every Monday we post a new video about the personal top 3 pans of famous pan people. If you don't want to miss out on a video, subscribe to our channel. This week we have a very special video of one of the best nib specialists in the world, Anabelle Hiller. Fun thing is that she is also the nib specialist of Appelboom, which means that she is the person who looks at your nib prior to shipping if you request this. She's currently in the store one day a week, but we hope to have her more days after she finished her goldsmith study and we can offer special nib grinds. We ask her what her personal top 3 pans are. Let's have a look.
Hi, welcome to my workbench. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Anabelle and I'm Appelboom's in-house nib specialist. You might have seen me appear in various cameos. There have been two. Other than that, the only reason why you would know me is because you've been to the shop or because you saw me at a European fountain pen show near you. Or not. That is also valid. I am here because Joost asked me to talk about my top 3 most special pens that I own. I think Aziza put it very well when she said top 3 most special pens doesn't necessarily mean most expensive pen or best performing pens you own, but the ones that are yours, the ones that you would never get rid of. And that's what I'm going to talk to you about now. Here they are. We're going to do this in a chronological order because I don't like to play favoritism. Number 1. This is the Pelikano Junior. I don't know the exact model name. I'm sorry. This pen is special to me because it was not only the first pen I ever owned, but also it's the first fountain pen I've ever reviewed. So I was 6 years old, and as the goody two-shoes that I am, I went to my primary school teacher and I asked her whether she needed help with anything. And she said, actually, yes, there is. She was sent this pen together with a survey, and they asked us to fill out a survey with a teacher and a student. I don't remember all the questions the survey had. I remember them asking whether it was a very safe pen to not roll off the desk because it has those little bumpy thingies and that could prevent it from rolling off the desk. That is all I remember. I also got a hat, I think. I think I got a yellow cap that said Pelikan on it. No idea what happened to that. But here's the pen. Is it a good pen? It's alright. Is it the best writing pen I've ever owned? Absolutely not. Is it very ugly? Yes. Do I mind? No. I love it. Next pen. Pen number 2 is a Montblanc 144.G from the 50s, I want to say. And I got it for my 18th birthday. I don't know what other people ask for their 18th birthday, but I wanted a fountain pen and I did research. Damn right, this is when I got into the fountain pen rabbit hole. This is when I started this whole adventure. I don't think I would have this job right now if it weren't for this pen. Though by far the most hilarious thing about this pen is the fact that it has a glass nib. The people back then in the shop said, because I'm left-handed, I'm more likely to break a gold nib. So we would be better advised to put in a glass nib. Can we take a moment to appreciate the irony that I was given a glass-nibbed pen because I might break a gold nib? I'm a nib specialist. I have fixed hundreds of gold nibs at this point, but will I ever change this for a gold nib? Absolutely not. This is iconic stuff. And off to pen number 3, which is probably the pen I would get most emotional about, and I'll try not to. It's a Parker Vacumatic made in the US in 1946, and I bought it at the Fountain Pen Hospital, which was founded in 1946. It is a lovely pen, and it writes nicely, and there's lots of things to love about it, but the reason I hold it so dear to my heart is I bought it during a trip to New York when I was asked to speak at a fundraiser about mental health awareness. It will forever remind me of the resilience it took to get me there, to be able to talk openly about those issues. And it reminds me of the people that got me there. It reminds me of the people I saw there that I miss a lot. I'm never ever going to get rid of this. And those are just some of the reasons why this pen is special to me. Okay, thank you for watching. Come to the shop sometime, we'll fix your pen. Thank you. Bye!